Good morning students, welcome to the online class of social studies. Today also we are continue the same chapter, lesson 3, timeline and calendar. In the previous class we study about the calendar. There are two types of calendar, Gregorian calendar and Saka calendar. And also the differences and similarities between the Gregorian calendar and Saka calendar we discussed the previous class. Today we are going to study the new topic, that is timelines. What is a timelines? Timelines represents the sequence of events in the order of occurrence. Timelines represent a sequence of events in the order of occurrence. We start from the earliest event and end up at the latest event. It tells us when a particular event had taken place in the past. So a timeline is useful to arrange events in the order in which they happened. Timeline is useful to arrange events in the order in which they happen. You can also make a timeline about the events of your life. How you will make a timeline? For example, suppose 2011, your date of birth. Then you can make according to that some events in your life, your date of birth. Then you took the admission in the school 2014. Then next, your sister was born or brother was born 2016. Suppose you participate any item in the, any program in the school, then you got some prize. That also you can arrange. Then 2019 grand birthday celebration or something like that important in your life. See the date 2011, the date of birth. Then 2014, you took the admission in the school. Then 2016, your brother or sister, birth of your brother or sister. Then again 2017, you got any prize. Then 2019, your birthday celebration. Like this we can make and a timeline. Just like about the timeline, we can also make a timeline of the date of birth of the family members. For example, how it will make? First your grandparents' date of birth, then your parents, your elder brother or sister, and your younger brother or sister. Like that you can make timeline. So what is timeline? It represents a sequence of events in the order of occurrence. And according to the order, we arrange this. So a timeline is useful to arrange events in the order in which they happened. Timeline are represent to study history. What is history? The previous class we study what is history. As you know, it is the study of the past, right from the earliest time to the present day. This means that in history we study long periods of time. To understand this, we need to study events in the proper order. That is what happened. And when so we use timelines in our study of history, because they tell us when an event happens, what happened before it, what happened after it. So we use timelines in our study of history because they tell us when an event happens. And next, what happened before it. And next, what happened after it. So we use timelines in our study of history because they tell us when an event happens, what happened before it and what happened after it. Just we'll go for example for understand better. The modern period starts from 1750 and is still continuing. So 1757 AD, the British defeated Siraj Dwara, the Nawab of Bengal. The British who had come to India for trade started participating in the administration of the country and soon brought the whole country under their control. But the Indians were unhappy to be ruled by the foreign power. Then in 1857, they revolted against the British, but the revolt collapsed. In 1858, the Queen of England took over the control of Indian territories. So after the failure of revolt of 1857, Indian leaders formed political organizations to free India from the British rule. In 1885, the Indian National Congress was founded that led the Indian freedom struggle. And finally, India won freedom in 15th August 1947. So here it is given, what happened before it, what happened after it. After the independence, what happened? After independence, India has made great progress in several areas. We have produced world-class scientists, engineers, journalists, socialists, soldiers, bureaucrats, politicians and doctors. We have built complex bridges and dams. We have sent satellites and rockets into space. India is on the way to become a superpower. So these all events we can make a timeline. How to make? So children, are you clear about the timeline? What is a timeline? Timelines represent the sequence of events in the order of occurrence. Why we use timeline in our study of history? We use timelines in our study of history because they tell us when an event happened, what happened before it, what happened after it. This all we can make a timeline. How to make a timeline according to the events happen? 1757. What happened? British defeated Siraj Ud Daula. British defeated. Next order. Then again 1857. Revolt against British. Again, 1885, Indian National Congress formed. Indian National Congress formed. Then again, 1947, 7 India become independent. India become independent. So here the question, see, when an event happens, can understand what happened before it, then what happened after it. See, the timeline is made according to the events happens. Now you are going to study the next topic, writing years in history. How to write years in history? Writing years in history. Writing years in history. In history, we use BC and AD with the years. It has been divided into these two broad categories on the basis of the birth of Christ. BC stands for before the birth of Christ, and AD stands for Anno Domini, which means in the year of Lord. So how to write years in history? BC and AD. BC means before Christ, and AD Anno Domini, which means in the year of our Lord. BC, before the birth of Christ. Before the birth of Christ. And AD, Anno Domini. Anno Domini. BC, before the birth of Christ. AD, Anno Domini. Historians consider the birth of Jesus Christ as the central point. They divide the events into those that happened before the birth of Jesus Christ, BC. For example, Ashoka ruled 269 BC to 232 BC. Ashoka ruled 200. Ashoka ruled 269 BC to 232 BC. States of the Aryans in North India when 600 BC. There were 16 major states of Aryans in North India. This all happened in BC, before Christ. And next, those that happen after the birth of Jesus Christ, that AD. Example, 1526 AD, 1757 AD, Sirajuddwala is the Nawab of Bengal. This all I will explain in detail. 1526, what happened? Babur invaded North India and laid foundation of the Mughal rule in India. And again, 1757 AD, British defeated Sirajuddwala, the Nawab of Bengal. And 1947, India finally won freedom. This all happened in AD. So this means that Emperor Ashoka came to the throne 273 years before Jesus Christ was born. And India became independent 1947 years after Jesus Christ was born. However, these days historians use BCE for BC and CE for AD. BCE stands for before common era,
and C stands for common era. To calculate years in BCE, look at the timeline. We count backward to count years in BCE. Thus, 400 BCE comes before 300 CE. Here you can see the timeline. Here, to calculate years in BCE, look at the timeline. We count backward to count years in BCE. Thus, first will come 400, then 300, 200, 100. It is count backwards. But the to calculate years in CE, we count forward to count years in CE. Thus, 400 CE comes after 300 CE. So, first 300, then only 400. But in BCE, first what will come? 400, then 300, 200. But in CE, 100, 200, 300, 400. It is forward counting and the BCE backward counting. BCE means before common era and CE common era. Children, today we study about the timeline. What is a timeline? Timelines represent a sequence of events in the order of occurrence. Two examples I have given. One is in whatever important things happen in your own life, you can arrange according to the order. Then also you can make a timeline in your family, your grandparents, birthday of your grandparents. According to the date of birth, you can make your parents, your siblings, etc. So timelines represents a sequence of events in the order of occurrence. Why we use timelines in our study of history? Why we use timelines in our study of history? Because they tell us when an event happened, what happened before it, what happened after it. So we use the timeline in our study of history because they tell us when an event happened, what happened before it, what happened after it. Then writing years in history. Writing, how to write the years in history? BC and AD. BC means before the birth of Christ. AD, Anno Domini, which means the year in the year of Lord. Some incidents have it to 2069 BC to 232 BC. Ashoka. These are examples. And timeline. Timeline is divided BCE, before the common era. CE, common era. Here the BC that counts backward counting. Okay. First will 400 BCE, then 300 BCE, then 200, like that it is coming. Then again here it is coming forward. 100 Z, 200, 300, 400 is a timeline. Today you have a question. What do timelines tell us? What do timelines tell us? 3 points. Timelines tell us when an event happened, what happened before it, what happened after it. The timeline tell us when an event happened, what happened before it, what happened after it. You have to study this answer. You have to study the answer. If you have the book, you have to read this topic, timeline, writing years in history, and next page also. Okay. And you have to make a timeline. According to this, you make a timeline in your copy. Okay, this is a homework for you. You have to make this timeline which is given in the book. It will come in the exam. Okay, thank you.